Lift your right hand and say, Father,
Father,
give me grace.
Give me grace.
Give me grace.
Give me grace.
To be positioned.
To be positioned.
Rightly.
Rightly.
For divine visitation.
For divine visitation.
Lift your voice up and begin to pray.
Shakabalabo,
shakabalabo,
shakabalabo.
Give me grace to be positioned rightly for divine visitation. Grace to be positioned rightly for divine visitation. Give me grace to be positioned rightly for divine visitation. Give me grace to be positioned rightly for divine visitation.
Somebody
say, Savior, Savior,
Savior,
you are my Savior, Savior,
my heart,
goodbye, my cry,
while on others thou art gone.
Father, we bless your name.
Hallelujah.
The song says, whilst on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. When you come knocking, when you come calling, we shall not be found wanting.
Amen.
When you come calling, when you come knocking, we shall not be found wanting.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, everyone, be seated in the presence of God. If you are in the corners, come to the center of the hall. Accept those protocols, Mama. Hallelujah. Praise God. Please, for everyone who's online, all the St. Vincent's, please, I want you to invite your friends. Come online. I want to address your nation tonight. Hallelujah. If you are St. Vincent online or Vincentian, I don't know what you call yourselves. Please come online. All Vincentians, let your people know that Apostle John is online. He wants to address your nation. Everyone, please grab your notepads, grab your Bibles, grab your pens. Hallelujah. Break your Bibles with me to Proverbs 24. I'm reading verse 27. Proverbs 24. I'm reading verse 27. Whilst on others thou art calling, oh,
do not pass me by.
Hallelujah. Whatever your wife, if you have Vincentian or Saint Vincent, whatever title you give yourself as a national of that country, let your families and your nation know that we want to address some nonsense. Hallelujah. Proverbs chapter 24, I'm reading verse 27. It reads, and I quote, prepare thy walk without, and make it fit for thyself in the field, and afterwards build thine house. I'll read that one more time. Proverbs 24, 27 says, prepare thy walk without, and make it fit for thyself in the field, and afterwards build thy house. Father, bless the reading of this word. Let it put on flesh in our lives, in our hearts, and give us power to live for you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are we alive in this house or want to get out?
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Proverbs 24, 27 says, prepare thy work without, and make it fit for thyself in the field, and afterwards build thy house. I'm here to give us a quick word charge titled, The Power and Importance of Preparation. Power and Importance of Preparation. On this occasion, is tailored to what? Kingdom advancement. an importance of preparation for kingdom advancement. If you fail to prepare, you are preparing to fail. If you hate preparation, you'll be eliminated by lack of it. I wasn't in the mood to preach tonight. I didn't even feel like coming to church tonight. But I felt I should come. I should just turn up. I was contacted by a few people telling me what's happening in St. Vincent. Please, if you are St. Vincent, how would they address themselves? Vincentians. Let your people know we are alive. I didn't want to turn up to church today. I lost appetite to preach today. But I said, no, we need to address some devils. I was told and I was sent today. I've been bombarded with messages from St. Vincent. Pictures and videos of a volcano already erupting. Not so. Smoke everywhere. People running helter skelter. The poor masses not knowing where to massively hide from a massive destruction pending. A nation in chaos. Isn't it funny that today, two prophecies were manifesting, the royal family and St. Vincent? With all of this happening, some idiots from that country still have the stupid audacity to be sending messages to us that, oh, we cooked up, we made up prophecy, we knew that there was an eruption pending, volcanic eruption pending. With everything still happening, let me just take it that those ones, they lack knowledge of spiritual matters. Let me now deal with what matters. What pained me the most was the crocodile tears of a wicked prime minister. A prime minister going on air and like a foolish and a disregarded celebrity crying crocodile tears. How many of his children are currently in St. Vincent? How many of his families are currently in St. Vincent? I want these courts. Those that like cutting, cut this one. How many of the prime minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, how many of his family members are currently in St. Vincent? A country that already has forecasted economically that in a couple of months' time they won't be able to pay people's salary anymore. But yet, his belly is fully loaded with stolen money. There's been a warning from God and warning from those that are specialists in volcanic monetization, but yet the government failed to prepare. Suddenly, you are panicking. Whoever fails to prepare is preparing for a pending failure. When things like this happen, it's only the poor and the weak and those that are helpless that suffer the most. The rich sort themselves out. When the wicked rule, the people mourn. But when the righteous rule, the land prospers. Every time there is a word of God for a people, a tribe, a tongue, a nation, a community, it's for God's agenda to be manifest there. A prime minister crying. A prime minister. start faking crocodile tears. This tear is not even up to crocodile tears, alligator tears. What a waste of a leader. The volcano is just making some noise. Everybody is shaking. Wait till it erupts. The warning that God gave that nation that when it will happen, I don't think you will ever recognize St. Vincent again. A prime minister crying crocodile tears. I want to see what nation he wants to prime minister after this disaster. Listen, I want to say this clearly and as a servant of God and a man from God. If any righteous man dies by this volcanic and earthquake doom coming to this nation, the prime minister is not permitted to leave the next day. God will kill him. I gave him a charge. I gave him a challenge, open challenge. Did he stand up and accept it? No.
No, sir.
I said if he was, his hands were clean of the blood of the innocent. I told you, Mr. Stupid Man, Mr. Whatever yourself, call yourself, Mr. Crime Minister. I told the crime minister of St. Vincent, if your hands were clean, pick up a Bible, a holy Bible, and stand openly. I've realized, I've been told you like going on national TV and radio very much. Hold the Bible there and tell the world that your hands were clean and your hands are clean. You never did it. If you did it, I want to say you that survived 7 days. But now hear me. My prayer for St. Vincent is this. And let me address, I'm not here to address the nation. I'm here to address the remnants. There are those in that nation that have cried to God. There are those in St. Vincent that have been in pain. There are those in St. Vincent that have fasted for the nation. There are those in St. Vincent and the Grenadines that loves God's kingdom. Yes, hear me, the Lord has sent me to tell you, you will not go down for the wicked.
Amen.
The remnant will not go down for the wicked.
Amen.
May God preserve the righteous in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May God keep the word of the righteous in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for yes, thou art with me.
Yes, sir.
Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. I prophesy over the nation of St. Vincent, yes, and the Grenadines, that the righteous blood will not flow on the altar of the wicked.
Amen.
Whoever is in power and those wicked men in occultic realm that are in leadership of that nation that refuse to heed to the warning of Jehovah, now disaster is pending and the poor are looking for a way out. People are struggling. People are hungry. People are sleeping on the floor. No provision on ground. Hear me, all righteous ones, righteous remnant of St. Vincent. The Lord said, he will not leave you comfortless.
Amen.
He will come to you.
Amen.
He shall 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 come to you.
Amen.
The blood of the righteous. Father, I pray that your mercy protects and preserves every righteous man, every righteous woman,
yes,
every righteous one,
yes,
young or old,
yes, sir,
white or black,
yes, sir,
from that nation,
yes, sir.
Father, let mercy preserve them.
Amen.
Let mercy preserve them.
Amen.
Let mercy preserve them.
Amen.
And Father, I release the broom of your wrath over St. Vincent, that the wicked will not come back to that nation.
Amen.
This volcano will erupt them out of position and out of that nation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please be seated. For those that want to cut, you can cut that one. Preparation. What is preparation? Preparation can be defined as the action or process of preparing. Thank you. Preparation can be defined as the action of or process of preparing or being prepared for use or consideration. If you hate preparation, you can't be considered for use. You can't work and live for God if you don't know how to plan your life. Failure to plan is planning to fail. Failure to plan is planning your life to fail. You cannot live life without a plan and put God on an emergency 99999 speed dial. God is not an ambulance, is not a firefighter. God is a God of plan and order. God created the world 6 days and on the seventh day he rested, meaning from day one to six, God had an agenda for creation. God was a good surveyor, hence the reason why in Genesis chapter 1, verse 2, the Bible says, and the Spirit of God moved over the surface of the waters, over the surface of the deep. It was dark, it was void, it was without shape or form. The earth was void. Darkness was upon the surface of the deep. After the Spirit had surveyed in Genesis 1:3, and God said, let there be light. God is a God of plan, is a God of preparation. God is a God of plan, is a God of preparation. Crocodile tears does not stop destruction. Don't know who I'm talking to. Crocodile tears does not stop destruction. Volcanic eruption cannot be thwarted or stopped by crocodile tears. I didn't know the man is a very good actor. Mr. Crime Minister of St. Vincent, you are a very good actor. Very good actor. What about the poor that have been crying for years in your nation? 20 years in office, nothing to show. What a shame. I don't blame him, I blame the nationals of that country. To tolerate the rule of a tyrant. Failure to plan is planning to fail. Preparation means the action or process of preparing or being prepared for use or consideration. Many even believers in church, you want to be a tool for kingdom advancement, but you don't live a life of preparation that God will use you. Without preparation, no godly consideration. God does not use a people that don't make plans. Many just live life, but nothing forecasted for the next 5 years. You will waste 5 years of life. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? What do you picture yourself doing by this time next year? A man that loves to plan is a man that will live life with two kinds of sight, foresight and long sight. Men that loves to plan live life with foresight and long sight. The planning ability of a man indicates the power of foresight he carries and the power of long sight he possesses. I don't know who I'm talking to tonight. What is preparation? Preparation is the proceeding or readiness for a future event. I don't know who I'm talking to tonight. Preparation is a proceeding or readiness for a future event. The proceeding and the readiness for a future event. For you to succeed in the future, for a future event to go well, your today's preparation is pivotal. It's pivotal. The Bible tells us, Proverbs 24:27, prepare thy work without. Meaning there should be, don't spare anything when preparing yourself. Don't spare any room when preparing yourself for the future event. Exhaust every resources. And listen, preparation requires your mental engagement. Meaning, even mentally, there should be no room spared when planning, when preparing. I would rather you have mental exhaustion through preparation than have mental decapitation through destruction. You are exhausted in the day of destruction. It means that you didn't exhaust your mentality and your mental state in the day of preparation. You understanding me? Prepare thy work without. God said, dump the word without means there should be no room spared. There should be no room spared. He says, make it fit. Listen, are you listening to me? What is tonight's message? What's the focus word? What's the word focus for tonight? What's tonight's message? Power and importance of preparation for kingdom advancement. For kingdom advancement. The greatest strategists in life are men that know how to plan and prepare. Great strategists are men that live life well prepared. If you go to battle without preparation, you will end up defeated and rattled in battle. If you go to battle without preparation, you will end up defeated and rattled in battle. Prepare thy work without and make it fit for thyself in the field. You see, listen, let's break down Proverbs 24:27. It's a three-step verse. Can I have it on the screen? Proverbs 24:27. First thing is to prepare yourself without sparing any room. First step. Number two step, it says, now make it fit for thyself in the field. Your preparation is your tool of execution in the field. How a man prepares determines how equipped he is on the life field. Then number three step, afterwards, build a house. Don't start building when you've not prepared, and don't start building when your preparation is not an equipped tool enough to build. If you build without preparation, you are building to crash. You don't need earthquake, you don't need volcanic eruption. St. Vincent's problem is not a volcano. St. Vincent's problem is poor planning. They were warned by God and warned by men and still did not take heed. And the prime minister is crying alligator tears. No, not prime minister, the crime minister. The crime minister. I saw him crying like Leonardo DiCaprio, Hollywood star. Nonsense. Three steps to preparation. Number one, prepare without. Number two, make your preparation fit for the field. And number three, build after. The three steps of preparation: prepare without sparing room. Number two, make sure your preparation is fit for execution. And number three, build. Build. Before we pray tonight, there are five things I want you to take home tonight about preparation. Five things to take home tonight about preparation. Number one, preparation is key to success. Failure to prep is failure to fail. It's prepping to fail. Failure to prep is prepping to fail. I said number one, preparation is key to success. Preparation is key to success. Simple. Proverbs 24:27. Prepare thy work without and make it fit for thyself in the land, then build. When you want to, you have an idea, prepare first. Don't start running for the idea. You will fail. Are you understanding me? Are you understanding me there? Failure to prepare is preparing to fail. Preparation is key to success. Number two, preparation is key to manifestation. 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 Number three, preparation is key to destiny preservation. I correct that. Preparation is key for destiny preservation. Preparation is key for destiny preservation. For destiny to be preserved, preparation must first precede the man. For your destiny to be preserved, preparation must precede your steps. If you want to waste your destiny, don't prepare. Just embark on a journey. You waste time, days, life, years, months with destiny. And remember, destiny is not a place. Let me correct something here. Destiny is not a place. Destiny is a journey. Yes. Destiny is not a place. We have this mentality that destiny is a place. No, destiny is your journey. So, for destiny to be preserved, preparation must proceed. Preparation is key for destiny preservation. The Bible says in Proverbs 22 verse 3, a prudent man foreseeth evil and hideth himself, but the simple person and they are punished. You want your destiny to be punished? You want to pay a high price in life? Don't live prudently by foreseeing. Preparation helps you with foresight and long sight for destiny preservation. Am I communicating here? Preparation helps you with foresight and long sight for destiny preservation. A prudent man, Proverbs 22 verse 3, foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple person and they are punished. Punishment is not always from one wicked uncle. Everybody blames the devil. The devil is innocent of so many accusations. Some powers of my father's house, man of God, oh servant of God, oh pastor, oh bishop, prophet, I need you to lay hands on me, lay feet on me, sit on me, pour oil on me, because the witches after my life, they are so much. Are you the only one which have time for? Please shut up. Preparation is pivotal for destiny preservation. A prudent man foreseeth. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple person and are punished, meaning they are wasted. They are dealt with. If you want to pay a very expensive price in life with your destiny, don't plan, don't prepare. Let me tell you something. Success doesn't come by luck. Success comes by hard work. Success, you see me standing here today, brother, it's not praying and fasting, it's hard work. It's planning, it's projection. Many times I've fallen, at the same time, I rise back up. It's a price I pay, a sacrifice I make on the altar of the journey to life called destiny. Destiny is not a location. Destiny is not a place. Destiny is your journey to living. When a man fulfills destiny, he starts living. So when a man is living, he's fulfilling destiny. Not just being alive. Some people are alive and wasting life. A prudent man may God give you eyes to foresee. I say, may God give you eyes to foresee.
Amen.
May God give you the discipline to plan.
Amen.
May God give you grace to prepare.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please be seated. A prudent man Number four, I said I'm giving you 5 points tonight before we pray. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. Preparation minimizes. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. The Bible tells us in the book of Proverbs chapter 6 verse 6 to 8. Can I have it up? KJV. Proverbs 6, 6 to 8. It says, go to the ants, ye sluggard. Ants, if ants don't waste, how much more you, human being? Do you know that through winter, ants don't come out? But once the sun starts shining, they invade your kitchen and your bedroom. Ants will come to your bathroom and take sponge and soap and go and hide for winter. And a whole grown, full human being is thinking like a goat, don't have soap. Thinking like a cow, don't have sponge. Ants will come to your kitchen, start packing seed of garri, store it in their store under the ground. Have a warehouse of garri and rice. Ants will put rice together, put beans together, and prepare for winter. But the whole human being will be hungry because of failure to plan. Go to the ants, ye sluggard. In Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 to 8. Go to the ants, thou sluggard, meaning thou lazy man, thou man that don't like, that lack the discipline to plan. Consider our ways and be wise. May God give us sense. May God give this sense to prepare. You know, they say common sense. Common sense is now expensive. Common sense is no longer common. You don't see it again. It's no longer common. Where some people are using their anus to think. A prime minister is crying. Is he crying the people need in St. Vincent now? Or they need a man that will stand and say, be calm, my people. God is with us. Actor. Oh, he thought that there is audition in Hollywood. Tell the crime minister of St. Vincent, they don't have an Arnold Schwarzenegger has acted Terminator, no more role. Commando has come and gone. Rambo has finished. The last one I watched was Rambo Last Blood. Go to the ants, thou sluggard. Consider our ways and be wise. Give me verse 7 there quickly. Proverbs 6, verse 7. Look at what the Bible says. Proverbs 6 says, which having no guide, overseer, or ruler. Ants don't have guides, they don't have overseer or ruler. Look at verse 8 quickly. Verse 8 says, provided a meat in the summer and gathered a food in the harvest. Ants don't have leader. They don't have an overseer. They don't have a prophet. They don't have apostle. They don't have teacher. But yet, they gather harvest. Preparation. Planning. 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 Ants they don't have a guide. They don't have anyone watching over them, but yet they gather harvest, they gather meat. Many of you walk face to face, hand in hand with a man of God, but you don't have evidence to show. What a shame. When someone will be thousands of miles, one word, their life change. What are they engaging or not engaging? No physical guide with them. They engage their grace from a distance. Go to the sluggard. Because of time, number five, quickly. I said I'm giving you 5 points about preparation. Number one, I said preparation is key to success. Number two, I said preparation. This doesn't sound right. I said preparation is key to manifestation. Number three, I said preparation is key to destiny preservation.
I don't know, something doesn't sound right.
Preparation is key to destiny manifestation, preservation. Number four, I said preparation minimizes the possibility of what? Waste. And number five, preparation destroys anxiety and extinguishes panic. Preparation what? Destroys. That's the one. I think it's, you're almost there. You're almost there with the sound. Preparation destroys anxiety and it extinguishes panic. The presence of panic is an indication of poor planning. The presence of panic is an indication of poor planning. I'm not saying that you don't go through stages in life or a stage in a vision where you're not faced with things that will make you panic, even though you've properly prepared. I'm talking about those that don't prepare at all. Panicking will always be part of their everyday living. The presence of panic is an indication of poor planning. The presence of panic is an indication of poor planning. The Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 38 verse 7. Ezekiel 38 verse 7. Be thou prepared and prepare thyself, thou and all thy company that are assembled unto thee, and thou shalt be a guard unto them. Planning makes you well guarded from panic. Preparation preserves you and keeps you from the position of panic. The presence of panic is an indication of the absence of poor planning. If you fail to plan and prepare, you become a scapegoat and a guinea pig on the laboratory table of waste. On the laboratory table of waste. Let me give you a couple of Bible verses before we pray tonight. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 21 verse 31, the horse is prepared against the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord. I want to close by saying something, child of God. There is what God will do for you and what he expects you to do for yourself. Don't call God for safety when your horse is not prepared for war. Your horse must be prepared for battle, then you call God for safety. Yes, victory belongs to the Lord, but the Lord still needs a horseman and a chariot. Am I communicating here? You are facing tribulation in life. You are facing trials in life. Stop calling God for safety when God is looking to you to mount your chariot, mount your horse, prepare for battle, and head towards battle. God will not fight for you if you are not positioned to also fight for yourself. God is a God that requires faith, but faith without your work, faith without engagement in battle is dead. Can I prophesy? Anyone under the sound of my voice who is facing defeat, who is panicking, who is anxious, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says be anxious for nothing, but with prayer and by prayer supplication, with thanksgiving, make your request known. I prophesy that tonight your battles are over. For those who have prepared well, your challenges are over. For those who have prepared well, your challenges are over. For those who have prepared well, your challenges are over. Your challenges are over. Your challenges are over. Your challenges are over. In the name of Jesus. We're going to pray. Simple prayer point. Father, give me discipline. And make me disciplined enough to be well prepared for life. Life has got no plan for anybody. Mama, you hear me? Life doesn't plan for you. You plan in life.
You good, bro?
Life doesn't plan for you. And life has got no plan for any man. You make plans in life. I'm going to say, Father, as I begin to pray, oh Lord, the discipline to prepare. The discipline to prepare my horse. Please open your mouth. The discipline to prepare my horse against the day of battle. Father, activate it in me. Lift your voice up and begin to fire prayer. The discipline to prepare my horse for battle. Open your mouth and fire that prayer. The discipline to prepare my horse for battle. The discipline to prepare my horse for battle. Father, as I open my mouth and as I pray tonight, let that discipline be activated in me. The discipline to prepare my horse for battle. Let that discipline come alive in me. Let it come alive in me. Open, where are the prayer warriors? If you fail to prepare, you're preparing to fail in life. Child of God, the Bible says, a prudent man prepares his horse for battle, but safety is of God. Before God shows up to save you, he must see you prepared for battle. Lord, the discipline. The discipline. The discipline to live a life well prepared. Father, let it come alive in me. 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 The discipline to be well prepared. The discipline to live a prepared life. Mashata. The discipline to prepare my horse. Where are the prayer warriors? I don't see praying people here. Who's praying? Please pray. The discipline. The discipline to live a well-prepared life. Lord, as I pray. Lord, as I pray. Oh Lord, as I pray. The discipline to lead a well-prepared life. The discipline to live a well-prepared life. Let it come alive in me. In the name of Jesus. Two more prayer points tonight. I hope this message is kicking something in you. Listen, please hear me. The worst thing you can do is to blame the devil for your own fault. Failure starts the day you start blaming others or someone else for your own error. There are people who are very good in blaming others for the decisions they made themselves. Oh, it is this man. This man caused it. No. Before the man caused it, what did you put in place for the man to cause it? Not everything is the devil's hand. A prime minister crying on national TV is not a leader at all. When a man is well prepared, you don't see tears. Come on now. When a man is well prepared, you don't see tears. You know what you see? You see faith. When a man is well prepared, you don't see tears, you see faith. One thing I stand assuredly on is faith. Because I prepare, I plan, and anything happens in between promise and fulfillment, I stand on faith. I say, Lord, you gave me the word, I planned, and I'm moving. You see a leader crying, what should the people do?
Leadership means lead a sheep. So when you are crying and leading a sheep, your eyes will be blurred with tears. You will lead people into the ditch. Leaders is not tears people want to see. They didn't vote you into power to cry. They voted into power to provide solution. Vincentians voted for a leader that we see in advance. Leadership requires insight. Hindsight. Oversight. Foresight and long sight. When the blind leads men with open eyes, even with their open eyes, they will end up in a well. I don't want to use the word that Vincentians are getting what they sowed. I won't use that. Because when the corrupt is in power, they know how to keep power for themselves. But God is intervening for that nation. Whether the devil, this, what is coming now? A broom has been released in heaven. All the debts in that nation will be swept into dustbin. Are you going to tell me that the prime minister will stay in the area of the volcano? He probably will be having his next broadcast in Canada or from America. Oh, Vincentians, how are you? And the poor are suffering. Someone sent me a video of how the masses, they are running like crickets trying to jump on a boat, on a ship. Where will people run to? Even without volcano, financial turmoil is not fired already. They've already forecasted 1 more month or 2 more months, no more salary. What will the poor survive on? But yet your belly is so fat it can feed the nation 2 years. A leader whose belly is fat like this must be flogged. How can a leader be fatter than the people he's leading? There are some visions that are hungry. Hunger has flogged them. Hunger has given them 6-pack on the front and the back. But their leader is carry belly like pots loaded with jollof rice and chicken. I am talking, but we don't know. If you know what is going on in that nation right now, you will cry. The cloud has gone blurred. Everywhere, people cannot see again. Smoke is in the air. But this is an indication of rapture as well. When rapture will come and hell open, I will see where many will run to. Preparation for those days. Two more prayer points tonight. Father, may I not live a life wasted, but a life well executed by right preparation. Lift your voice and say, my Father, as I begin to pray, someone open your mouth and repeat after me. My Father, as I begin to pray, oh Lord, may I not live a life that becomes wasted. May I not live a wasted life, but oh Lord, help me live a life well executed by good preparation. A life well executed by good preparation. Lift your voice up, open your mouth, and fire that prayer. Malabalagadash. Open your mouth and pray. Abashadadadash. Mashakatabaladash. Hey! Oh! May I live a life well executed by the right preparation. Open your mouth and pray. Pray. In the name of Jesus. And our last prayer point tonight, you're going to lay your hands on your head. Father, the wisdom to properly plan and be prepared. Father, no, the Lord wants to change that prayer point. Preparation that brings fortification to my destiny. Father Lord, help me engage such. Preparation that brings fortification to my destiny. Father, help me engage such. Lift your right hand up and say, my Father, my Father. Lift up your right hand and say, my Father, my Father. As I begin to pray, the preparation, the level of preparation that brings fortification concerning my destiny. Oh Lord, help me engage such. Lay your right hand on your head and fire prayer. The fortification that brings preservation for my destination in life. Help me engage such. Open your mouth and pray. Mashata balado. Open your mouth and pray. Oh,
oh. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty.
Lift your voice and say,
you're a faithful God. Awesome is your name.
You do mighty things, say,
you do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God.
I stand amazed in your presence. There is nothing you cannot do. I stand amazed
in your presence.
In your presence, say, there is joy, peace, and hope. Thanks tonight. We bless your name.
Amen.
We've received the word. We've released words from our mouth through prayers. Pray that the words of our mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in the name of Jesus.